where Roy Moore is making race-based appeals, where last night, Roy Moore actually said, he came out of hiding and said, we should talk about the issues. But all he focused on was blasting the Washington Post and then talked about transgenders in the military.
Yeah, I saw that.
Not about what Doug Jones has been hitting me on. How can this man trash talk about education when Alabama is 49th in the country when it comes to education? No, because even Roy Moore is appealing to base whiteness. That's what's going on there. So the question is, even in that state, what will happen when it comes to black voters? What will happen when it comes to educated white voters in Alabama? What will take place? Joining us right now is State Senator Hank Sanders from Alabama. Senator Sanders, we're looking at what took place with Donald Trump yesterday with Native Americans in the White House. We see the race base, and he tries to frame it as, oh, this Christian appeal, if you will. Are black voters critically important when it comes to this election? Are they rejecting Roy Moore, and are they going to turn out in massive numbers to defeat him at the ballot box?
First, let me say that it's a pleasure to be with you. And I think the last time we were on, we were dealing with Confederate memorials. But to respond to your question is, one, I don't have any doubt that black voters will reject Roy Moore. I do have some doubt about how much black voters will turn out. I certainly have been doing everything I can to try to increase that. My wife, Fire Rose Teray, whom you know, has also been leading the voter die movement to try to let people know. So there are many African Americans who don't know that there's a vote on December the 12th, not to speak of how important it is, because you're not only rejecting Roy Moore if you can win, what you're doing is getting one more vote in the United States Senate.
But hey, how do they not know? I mean, it's not like this race has not gotten a lot of attention in Alabama.
It's gotten a lot of attention in Alabama, but most folks do not watch TV1. Most folks don't watch MSNBC. Most folks don't watch CNN in Alabama.
Well, what do they watch? What do they listen to?
Some of them watch the local news. Some of them don't watch other programs that don't have anything at all to do with the news. So that means you have to go to voters directly, you have to educate them, and you have to mobilize them. And there has not been that kind of mobilization in the black community. And I think that's part of the problem.
When you talk about that, is Doug Jones doing enough? Are you saying it's also a resource issue where it's not happening?
Well, it certainly has been a resource issue up until this week. But then you got you're trying to do all of this in 2 weeks. It's certainly been a resource issue. As far as I know, there wasn't any resources in the black community up until Wednesday evening just before Thanksgiving.
Do you believe that Roy Moore is turning off, let's say, educated white voters in suburban counties in Alabama, suburban cities in Alabama, or do you believe that his Christian-based appeals by saying Doug Jones, his comments about homosexuality, or even when it comes to abortion, that's going to sway those white voters?
Well, I don't know the answer to that, but I do know that white supremacy is still very powerful in Alabama. It's deep and it's broad. And so I think that there are a substantial number of whites who will vote for Doug Jones. But I believe in order for him to win, he has to truly mobilize the black vote. Because if he doesn't mobilize the black vote, then you got a problem. And I do think that there was some feeling that if somehow you try to mobilize the black vote, in the process, you're going to turn off the white vote or turn on more of the white vote for Roy Moore. I believe that you have to get out your base and then you build on that with other people. And you can't worry about if you mobilize your base, whether or not you're going to somehow mobilize somebody else's base.
All right, then. State Senator Hank Sanders will be focused on this race through December 12th. So we certainly see what happens there. We certainly appreciate it. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, and this is a very important race.
Weekdays on TV One.
I will never lie to you.
Oh, my God.
Roland Martin.
He doesn't want to talk to us. He wants to ignore us.
Uncensored.
Hell no!
No.
That ain't gonna cut it, boo.
Unapologetic.
No, that is fundamentally false. You are wrong.
Unfiltered.
He wants an America where we all look alike. He ain't talking about black people.
Unrelenting.
You better go work out, because you got a fight on your hands.
News One Now with Roland Martin, weekdays at 7 a.m. on TV One.